He's a fine musician.
Yeah, and?
And? I think you and your mother have let a pair of leather pants get in the way of your better judgment. In a couple of areas.
And what areas are those, Pop?
Exactly. What areas of judgment are we talking about here, Pop?
Are you going to get off your high horse and going to listen to me?
I'm going to listen to you.
I agree with you. The man has potential. He has a nice, natural way with the lyric. And he has a nice voice, too. Great presence. But he's missing something that's much more important, especially in the music business. He doesn't have the fire.
The fire? What, are you kidding me? Do we just hear the same guy sing? He exudes energy on that stage. I mean, he's oozing with charisma.
Lois, he's not motivated.
Motivated, schmotivated. The crowd went crazy over him. How much more motivated do you want, Pop?
I'm not talking about what he's getting from them. I'm talking about what he gets from inside. Lois, I've been around musicians all my life, so I know the difference. Your guy's not hungry. That cat has seen the cream. He doesn't need this.
Am I nuts, Ma? Am I nuts? Of course he's not hungry, because he's lucky enough to have a day job. He eats regularly. Is that a sin, Carmine?
Yeah. So what's wrong with having a successful business side too, Pop?
Well, I say it adds a dimension to him. It makes him more rounded and more sensible, in fact.
It won't play, Gloria.
Sure it will. He's got an attitude. I don't need it. Come and get it. It's very attractive.
Yeah. Hey, Pop, not everybody has to make it the hard way like you did.
You two think I don't know what's going on in front of my nose? I know you have a lot invested here. I also know it has to do with a lot more than how well Eddie sings. But you asked my opinion of the man as a musician, so I'm giving it to you.
Yeah. Well, you've gone too far. This is Lois and Eddie's night. You do not have to run him down, Carmine.
So now it's Lois and Eddie's night. See, Gloria, you're proving my point.
So I'm interested in him, Pop. Sure. So what's wrong with that?
What do you think?
You know, you say that every single time, Pop. You know, every single time I bring a guy home to meet him, he always has to make trouble.
You think I just like giving people a hard time? Lois, I'm your father. I don't want to see you getting hooked up with somebody who's going to take you for a ride.
Eddie's not like that, Dad.
Then why did you bother to ask me?
All right, maybe Eddie got nervous because you're here. Maybe, Ma, Eddie didn't look hungry enough, you think, because Pops was sitting here scowling at him all night long.
No, I wasn't scowling.
Hello, everybody. So, are we having a good time?
Hi, Eddie. Come on, I want you to sit down. Excuse me. I got a couple of questions to ask. You put on a good show tonight.
Oh, thank you. You were a great audience.
You were wonderful.
Thanks.
Yeah, sure he was. Who wouldn't love him?
I was just telling Lois and Gloria that you have a very nice way with the lyric. And I like your sound, too. Mm-hmm. Especially on the oldie covers. very delicate balance. Nice nod to the original without being a parody. And you know how to leave them wanting more, too.
Well, I'm just doing what comes naturally.
Yeah. You're an entertainer as well as a musician. And that's what it takes to make it these days.
We're counting on that.
What surprises me is that somebody with your obvious talent is still holding on to his day job. My music is, it's just a sideline to you. Wait. Makes me wonder if you really have what it takes to go all the way.
Well, I know that I have some decisions to make. But if it's true, as you said, I have the tools, then I guess it's just a matter of when, isn't it?
Either you want it or you don't.
Wait a minute. And no disrespect, but didn't you give it all up so you could run the sporting goods store?
That's right. I gave up my career so I could support a family. I didn't try to do two things at once. Besides, by that time, I already had my career. I'm talking about commitment, Eddie. It concerns me, a guy who can't commit to his talent.
Oh.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying here? How do we know he's going to commit to anything else, either?
And where would that leave Lois?
Wait a minute. Are we talking about what I think we're talking about here?
Yeah, I think we are.
I thought we were. Pops, we are not in Bensonhurst. I am not 15 years old, and Eddie is not one of the boys from the neighborhood.
Yep, this is true.
So then lay off, would you? What is up with the third degree?
Lois is right. Tonight is not the night for this.
No. This is fine. Mr. Cirillo, I understand your feelings. I mean, why shouldn't you be protective of Lois? She's the most precious thing in the world to you, right? And let me tell you something. She is to me, too. I would never do anything to hurt Lois. I have nothing but the most honorable intentions towards her.
You see, Carmen, everything is fine. See?
Intentions are one thing.
Oh, geez, Pop.
Let me explain something. My life was set. I mean, I had a career. I was rolling along just fine. Happy, content, satisfied. And then suddenly, out of the blue, this bolt of lightning came at me. Your daughter. And she changed my life. I started getting back feelings that I hadn't had since I was a little kid. Good feelings. Creative feelings. Exciting and scary feelings. Lois talked me into this whole thing by the sheer force of her will. Because I didn't want to change my life. Because of her, I'm giving this whole thing a try. And I know that that's why I'm kind of torn between the two. And that's what's giving you a problem. But just try to remember that there's a lot at stake for me here.
You both have a lot at stake here.
Exactly. That's why I have to be absolutely sure before I do something irrevocable.
That makes sense to me.
I don't know, Eddie. How long does it take for a guy to make up his mind?
How could he do that to me? How could he stick his nose in our business like that?
Easy. He's a father.
Yeah, well, that's no reason to put pressure on us. And they wonder why I left Bensonhurst.
You got a point, though.
I am so embarrassed. I invited them here to give us moral support, not to run us into the ground.
He's right, Lois.
What do you mean he's right?
Well, I am on the fence. It's what I've chosen, but even to me, it's starting to feel like I'm stuck between a rock and a hard place.
Wait a minute, Eddie. Now you are really confusing me. You have been selling me so hard on the idea of keeping your two lives separate.
I know. But I realize I should make a decision about my music and about our future together.
Our future together?
I don't know what to do, but your father's right. I need to do something. I mean, I can't stay on the fence forever.
Well, that's a big decision to make, you know, but you don't have to make it tonight.
Well, I appreciate that, Lois, but believe me, it's on my mind a lot.
Like me?
Like you.
Okay, well then, you should take your time making up your mind, okay? Because it's important, and I want you to be sure. And then when you do know, you can give me the answer.
such a wonderful girl.
Of course, if it's the wrong answer, I'll break both your legs, but no pressure.
Lois, I'm serious. You deserve better than a part-time commitment.
Absolutely right. I deserve everything I've ever wanted. But, you don't always get everything you deserve.
And you know, of course, I'm not just talking about the band. I'm talking about us.
Yeah.
I'm talking about a whole way of life that I've grown very accustomed to.
Yeah.
And a whole other way of life that you represent that is very, very appealing to me.
Well, that's what I've been trying to tell you. All right, but enough pressure, okay? Why don't you get up on stage, earn your keep. You got another set to do. Come on, go. Go.
You know, there is no one in the entire world like you. You know that?